So welcome back po sa channel. So ito na po yung part 4 sa library management. So on this video guys, ang gagawin natin is itong sa manage group. So mag-add lang po tayo dito ng another form. Then form group. Okay, then properties, okay, then mag-add tayo ng label, then text box, so font size lagay natin siya ng 10. Okay, so then group ID, then ito is group ID, okay, then copy. Okay, then ito group name. Then group name. Okay, then group record. So then mag-add tayo ng list view. Okay, then dito sa properties, so details, and then hanapin natin dito yung grid lines, then true. Okay, then mag-add tayo ng button, so copy lang. Okay, then btn submit, and submit, then btn update, then update, delete, then btn delete. Ito is reset, then btn reset. Okay, so next dito sa form dashboard, so click ang add new. Okay, and then copy lang natin to. Then form group, okay, then dito sa group, so click ang submit. So then if group ID the text equals empty, then message box that show please enter group ID. Then required. Then message box button dot okay, then message box icon dot warning. Okay, then else. So if object dot state equals connections state dot close, then object con dot open. Okay, then com equals com equals new holidb then insert into table group. Okay, then values. So dito i-select natin ang table group name. So table group name. Okay, so table group name, then ID. Okay, so dapat i-insert natin siya dito. So values, then i-call natin ang text boxes natin. So group ID the text then group name the text then object. Okay, then com dot execute non query then list view 1 dot clear then call. So i-call natin ang form load. So balik tayo dito sa designer then click ang form load sender A and then message box. So lagyan natin ng successfully inserted then message then information. Okay, then object dot close. Okay, so the next dito tayo sa so mag-create po tayo ng so pag-display sa record. So public sub read data then list view 1 dot columns dot add then group ID then horizontal dot center then group name okay then try if object con state dot connection state dot close then object dot open then com equals new holidb then select all from table group so i-display natin siya then dr equals com dot execute reader then while dr.read Okay, then dr.close and object.close. Okay, then under sa dr, mag-create po tayo ng function dito. So public sub, add data to list view. Okay, then Bible. Then as list view. Then Bible group ID as string. Then group name. As string. Okay, then dime. As new list view item. Dot items. Dot add. Then lv dot text equals group id dot sub items dot add, then i-call natin ang group name. Okay, so yun guys, then i-call natin siya dito, so call. And then list view 1, then dr, then dr 1. Okay, then itong read data, so i-call natin siya sa form load para automatic mag display ang record. Okay, so i-try natin. Okay, so click manage, then new. So mag-try tayong mag-add. So ID is 2022, then group name test, then submit. Okay, so nag-display siya dito. Okay, so yan guys. So then next, dito tayo sa update. Okay, so then i-click natin itong update button. Then if group ID the text, then copy natin yung message back natin dito. Then else, then try. Okay, then if object con dot state, equals connection state dot close, then object con dot open. Okay, then com equals new, then update table group set, i-select natin ang value dito, so group name. And then i-call natin ang text box group name. then where, i-call natin ang group ID. Then equals, i-call natin ang group ID dot text. Okay, then object com dot execute nan query, then list view 1 dot clear, then call, so read data. Then, lagyan natin siya ng message. So, successfully updated. Then, message. Then, information. Okay, then, object.close. Okay. So then next, dito tayo sa delete. So copy lang po natin ito. Okay. Then ito naman, palitan natin siya ng successfully deleted. Okay, then ito, palitan natin siya ng delete from table group, and then where stored ID, okay, so table group, then where group ID, yan, okay. So next, dito tayo sa reset. Sa reset button, so i-call lang po natin itong group id.clear. Then group name.clear. Okay? Then dito tayo sa ano? Sa text box group ID. Okay. Then dime I as integer. Then list view 1 dot select I selected items dot clear. Then group ID that text a focus, then try if me that group ID that text equals empty, then group name that text equals empty. Then else for I equals 0 to list view 1. That items that count minus 1. Then if group ID that text equals list view 1, dot items dot sub items dot text, then group name dot text equals list view 1 dot items dot sub items dot text, then list view 1 dot items that's dot selected equals true. Okay, so then next dito sa list view natin, so dito sa events, then hanapin po natin ang selected index change. Okay, so double click and then dime then dime I as integer then for I equals 0 to list view 1 dot items dot count minus 1 then if list view dot items dot selected equals true, then group ID dot text equals list view dot items dot sub items dot text. Okay, then exit 4 then list view dot focus then list view one dot false full row select equals true. Okay, so i-try natin. So click manage, add new. Okay, then i-try natin i-update. So from test to good then update. Okay, so successfully updated and then dito tayo sa delete. Okay, successfully deleted then reset. So yan guys, working na yung sa group natin. Okay, so try tayong mag add then test. Okay, so yun guys, success yung pag-add natin. Okay, so yan lang guys, and please follow the tutorial and don't forget to subscribe and support my channel, Sir's Code Page, and God bless.